this, ay. Yeah, I'ma act a fool with this, ay. Yeah, I'ma act a fool with this, ay. I turn the knob, can't resist, I'm incredible. Yeah, came for the dollars, call it vegetable. Then I did the dash, can I catch me, bro? Ooh, then I did the dash, can I catch me, whoa? Your whole team is no competition. Boy, I did it by myself, it's a solo mission. Running up the charts, I'm a fool, dog. Turn the whole field to a schoolyard. Bunch of students ain't eating around here.
It is perhaps the best home field advantage in all of football, and certainly the loudest, as we welcome you inside Arrowhead Stadium in Kansas City. Nothing like the fanfare of introductions to an NFL game, and that was in evidence a moment ago. Fireworks, pyrotechnics, you name it, this crowd is ready as their guys get set to match up between the Brooklyn Bulls and the Kansas City Chiefs.
Will Lutz set to kick off.
Set to go now in week 6 of the NFL season, and we are underway on EA Sports.
Now this will make it into the end zone. And ultimately cannot get this out to the 25-yard line as he's dropped at the 23.
At their own 23-yard line.
First carry here for Joe Mixon.
And yeah, nice yardage right off the bat here as he's up to about the 24-yard line. 4 yards the result on the first play from scrimmage. Second down. Joe Mixon. Give him 4 on the carry, and it'll make this a 3rd and about 2.
Back-to-back 4-yard runs. Now look, if they just do that all the way downfield, ball ends up in the end zone, but that's a little difficult to do.
Yeah, I think now 3rd and 2, that defense ready to stiffen up and stop that run. An early test, 2 plays in. This is 3rd and 2. Here's a quick throw out left. It's complete. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line.
Curtis Samuel.
They pick up the first down there with a gain of 11. That time the conversion comes courtesy of the RPO.
And know what it did? It moved the sticks. Nice pickup on 3rd down. Even better decision.
On 1st down, he'll drop to throw. Trying to get it to Williams, but it's intercepted. Picked off at the 45. Well, it's no secret he's had trouble this year with interceptions, and this is a bad start for him. First drive, throwing another pick.
No matter who's broadcasting his game, that's how the conversation begins. Throwing too many interceptions. Can he take care of the football? If I were his backup, I'd be edging towards the coaches and saying, hey, how about giving me an opportunity?
They'll run for the first time with DeAndre Swift.
And they go backwards here, losing yardage back at the 48-yard line. 2 yards the loss, 2nd and 12.
Nice play right there to stop him behind the line, but I want to see how this defense continues to play him here in the first half.
Yeah, we know, you know better than I, he has the ability to take over a game, so what do you do?
Yeah, I think you have to make sure that you bottle him in at varying levels, because if you crowd everyone to the line of scrimmage, if he breaks through, it's nothing but room to run.
To throw on 2nd down, Meadows. He's going to hit his man out of the backfield. Complete.
Meadows pass.
It'll be a gain of six, and they're going to have a third down.
They've got good playmakers on the offensive side of the ball. I don't know what happened last week to really hurt their performance and hold down their production, but I would dare say that this week in practice, there's a lot of talk about how they're going to increase their proficiency.
And that was a good start, getting the playmakers involved. You mentioned that to me pregame. That's what they did there.
Yeah, I think a lot of people think the coaching staff really gets on them, and that's how they motivate them. Most of these guys are self-motivated. They have a lot of pride in their performance.
Great way to convert on third down there. 21 yards the play. Meadows. Oh, and this ball's tipped and intercepted. William Jackson with a pick. And the return will stop right around the 25. Unfortunately for him, if last week was any indication, we knew a pick was coming at some point. Last week it was interception after interception, and here we go again.
We actually quit counting last week at a certain point because I thought I was going to run out of fingers, all right, because I'm not all that skilled as a mathematician. But you're right. It felt like a matter of time, and you got to think the guys on defense, they couldn't wait for this opportunity after what they saw on tape.
He's just going to dump this one off to his fullback out of the backfield.
Complete.
They'll come up now second and four from the 31.
Brings up second and four at the 31-yard line.
Now a throw complete to his fullback out of the backfield. And he'll be brought down right around the 37. 6 yards the pickup, and that's a first down.
First down, Brooklyn.
They'll drop the throw. Got his man complete over the middle. That's Underwood. And taking it across midfield and inside the 45.
19 yards.
Right about 20 yards on the pickup. Officially, they'll say it's going to go for 19. They'll look to throw again. Caught left side, Williams. And he'll lose yardage on the play back at the 45-yard line. He was unable to shake free there, and they'll cover him for a loss of a yard.
At the 45-yard line.
They'll stick with the passing game as he looks to throw. Man open left side, it's Williams. And he'll go out of bounds right around the 40. That catch good for five. It's third down.
Brandon, perfect defense in this situation would have meant that there was an incompletion. They would have picked it off. Okay, so they gave up the completion. But I really enjoyed watching how the defense stayed in sync, stayed in great communication. And as he dragged across each zone, you see him pointing, communicating. There he is, and they passed him off to each defender. Ended up making a nice play, even though it was complete.
On third down, he'll drop to throw. Throwing the out route and complete. It's Underwood. Second catch for him today, and it'll wind up a first down.
A gain of nine.
Timing is everything, and they work on this cut all the time. They work on all the timing patterns, and this time it paid off for him. Worked him to the center of the field, cut it to the outside. Ball's delivered, gets both feet down for the completion.
And he will lose yardage back to the 34-yard line. A loss of a full 3 yards, and now it's second down. Out of the gun, they'll look to throw. He's going to let this go. Back of the end zone. And that'll be incomplete. Took a pretty good shot as he tried to pull that one in. Couldn't hang on third down.
Well, he's been targeted quite a bit on this drive, and finally I think the guys on the defensive side, they said no more. They slapped the double coverage on him, made it very tough for him to get the ball.
Ninth play of the drive coming up, and certainly not an easy one on third and long. Now they'll throw here, out of the gun. That is caught inside the five. And all the way in for the touchdown.
Justin Hopkins.
This is a crew, they've come out flat their last two games, both losses, but just judging by the energy level, they look different here early, and that touchdown shows how.
Yeah, it seems to me that that touchdown gets them off the treadmill. Because, you know, you've been on the treadmill. I've seen you work out. You go forever and ever, and it tells you you've gone somewhere, but you really have. You're in the same spot. They've exchanged it. for an escalator. Still got some hills to climb, but they can get there.
These are good analogies. I run outside sometimes, so you know, get some fresh air, a little sun on your face.
A little wind in there.
Yeah, that's right.
KC offense out of the huddle, ready for their next drive. They had the interception last time. It led to the opening touchdown. So now 7-0 the score as they start first and 10. A throwing to start the drive, but that one incomplete.
Normally you think the tight end's going to be able to catch the football and handle that contact, but in this case, maybe a little too much target to hit. That one was timed well. Incomplete.
An incomplete pass leads to 2nd and 10 from the 25. To throw again. Meadows taking a deep shot here for... It got his man complete. The 20. And he takes this into the end zone for a Chiefs touchdown. Mecole Hardman, his 5th touchdown now on the year. And the Chiefs are an extra point away from tying up this football game. And it's no good. He misses the extra point, and this remains a 7-6 game.
Will Lutz set to kick off.
Now he's back out there to boom this one away, maybe with some frustration after the PAT miss. Now this will make it into the end zone. And only able to get this to the 19, so probably should have opted for the touchback.
19-yard line.
This is it! This is it!
The offense back out there at the line, ready for their next drive. And they're hoping to redo their efforts of the last drive when they got into the end zone.
And just think of what it's like now on the sideline, because when you score a touchdown, you have to go over and look at the tablet and see what you did on the last drive. When you scored points, it's a whole lot better view than when you're trying to figure out how to fix things there.
Nice way to start the drive, a gain of 12 and a first down.
First down.
They go play action here on first down. This is brought in by Gibson. And he's going to be brought down on what will be the final play of this first quarter. After one, a one-point game, 7-6. 6 yards was the pickup on the last completion, so here's 2nd and 4. And he'll get up to the 43-yard line. 6 yards the pickup, and that's a first down.
It's a gain of 6. And
from the shotgun, he'll look to throw. Open man is Samuel, complete. And he'll work it across midfield inside the 45. 13 yards, and it keeps the drive moving.
First down, Bulls.
Now a shotgun snap as they'll look to throw. Eluding the pressure right. And this will be incomplete. They don't get the hook up there, but you really have to marvel at how precise he's been throwing the football these last couple weeks.
Oh, that's a perfect word for it, precise, because if you're at 70% or better 2 weeks in a row, you have a job as long as you want one in this league, won't you? I mean, let's face it, it's not just West Coast offense either. He's putting the ball downfield as well.
So after the incompletion on first, now 2nd and 10. And he's going to be hit and taken down. Back right around the 48-yard line.
I think normally we would talk about this more with basketball players and football players, but let's adopt it in this case. He's a stat sheet stuffer.
Had the interception earlier, now a sack. What, he just needs a touchdown for the trifecta.
That's about all he needs, and he's going to go for it.
Offense on third down today. A perfect 3 for 3 as they look to keep that streak going. This will be a tough 3rd and 18. Going to for a right side here. Complete. And he is out of bounds inside the 35. The defense shaking their heads, not aggressive enough, and they allow him to convert a 3rd and 18. So now 1st and 10 in Chiefs territory at the 34. He'll drop to throw. And he'll be hit as he releases it, and that'll fall incomplete.
Well, we always talk about how you've got to be quick when you go through your progressions, and here's another prime example. Trying to look downfield, he was standing in the pocket, but just couldn't find anyone open, could he?
No, not enough time. They hit him and forced that incompletion. And they'll be inside the 25 now at the 24. 9 yards, and that leaves them just short, so it'll be 3rd and less than a yard.
Gain of 10 brings up 3rd and inches.
The offense on 3rd down tonight, a perfect 4 for 4 thus far. They're looking at 3rd and a few inches. They give to Mixon to try to pick it up. And he won't be close to a 1st down as he runs into a wall right around the line of scrimmage. They'll be marked inches short. No gain on the play. And that's going to lead him to 4th down. Very makeable field goal try from here, but instead they're going to go for it. 56. They'll try and sneak it here, and he'll burrow his way forward to pick up the 1st. Just a gain of 3, but they'll certainly take it as they convert on 4th down. Credit there goes to those guys up front.
Certainly does, but we're also seeing how quarterbacks are doing it nowadays on the sneak. When I played high school ball, my coach John Ford used to say, just get down behind those guys and pick up the 1st down. Now these guys might hesitate a count, use their vision and their eyes, and find the crease and dive for it that way.
Now this time he'll look to throw. Throw right side, complete to Williams. And this one goes nowhere. Losing yardage back at the 22. He was unable to shake free there. They'll cover him for a loss of a yard. 2nd and 11. It's caught on the right side. Williams.
The pass.
That catch good for only a yard, and it'll be 3rd down.
Well, they're unable to convert that into much, but it's never a bad idea to try to get the ball into a tight end of his caliber's hands and see what kind of disruption he can cause.
Out of the gun now on 3rd down. And he's going to have to eat this one as down he goes. And now following that sack, looks like we've got an injured man down there on the field. We'll step aside and get an update when we return to Arrowhead. And his kick is good. Didn't hit it all that well, but he got enough on it to put it through. And they bump the lead up to 4 now at 10-6. That will go down as a 15-play drive, and it results in 3 points. So some disappointment?
It's funny, we had our conference before the game with the offensive coordinator, and what did he tell us? I just want every drive to end in a kick, right? Extra point, a punt, or a field goal? Well, in this case, I think it is a little bit of a disappointment because it did end in a kick, but that type of a drive should end in the end zone.
The Chiefs offense about set to begin this drive. They'll start on the ground with Swift. And he will lose yardage here back at the 23-yard line. He'll lose a yard there, and it's 2nd and 11.
It's a loss of a yard. Brings up 2nd and 11 at the 23-yard line.
Mark 38. Hey, here we go. Looking to throw on 2nd down. Meadows, he'll rifle this one deep right side. It's caught inside the 25. And all the way in for a Kansas City touchdown. A big play there. 77 yards. And the Chiefs have taken the lead. A nice throw there by the second-year quarterback.
And I don't believe that was the kind of play he would have made as a rookie, because usually your rookie season is a continuation of your college days. A lot of one read, and if you don't have it, you just take off and go. Now he's settled in the pocket a little bit more, reading the field and getting to a second and sometimes third progression. That was a nice play.
After the touchdown, Lutz to kick it off. And they will not get a chance to return this one as it's through the end zone for a touchback.
25-yard line.
The offense now at the line, ready for their next drive. And they had a long drive last time, but they had to settle for a field goal, and I'm sure that's how it felt to them, settling. They probably should have gotten in the end zone.
Yeah, not out and out joy, right? Because that's what you get when you put the ball in the end zone. But there are benefits to that type of a long drive. Your defense gets a chance to take a break, adjust a little bit, maybe get themselves ready to get back out on the field and play a little bit better. So they'll take the benefit even though they wanted the 6 points.
And maybe wore down the other defense. We'll see. Out of the shotgun, they run with Mixon. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. 16 yards, a first down.
A gain of 16 yards.
Back to Mixon on first down. And the result here, a pickup of 8. Leaves him with 2 to go on second down. And that looked like some pretty easy yardage there right up the gut.
And he's a guy that has some height to him. So when you don't have to drop a shoulder or create or get through contact or trash, makes it a lot easier to stay upright, see the field, and make a run as we just saw there.
To throw on second down, McAllister. Oh, he's going to let this go for the end zone. Into heavy traffic, and it's intercepted. Picked up by Jesse Bates. And he will take this all the way up past the 40-yard line. That throw, Charles, over the middle of the field, and a few too many bodies in there got picked.
That's a normal situation, too, isn't it? No matter how hard you try and spread the field sometimes, there's always going to be a traffic jam, it feels like, towards the middle. And if there's any type of a missed throw, or maybe the ball's tipped, or just too many bodies in the area, an interception can result.
Into a double team, and it's intercepted. Trey Flowers picks it.
That was a really nice interception. I think it illustrates the differences between playing man and playing zone. When you're in man, all you're focused on is the receiver in front of you. But when you're in zone, you're allowed to read the quarterback's eyes and go to the ball. That's exactly what happened on that play.
The offense back out there at the line, ready for their next drive. Well, what's the plan of attack here? Very late second quarter, and look where the ball is.
Yeah, a bad spot for you, but the defense has all three timeouts. So what you're telling your team is ball security number one. It's not all on the running backs if you decide to run the football. That offensive line has got to protect them and wedge out some space, because you can't just kneel. They take three timeouts. They're going to get the ball back in good field position with a chance to put points on the board. You've got to try and get a first down and run out this first half.
5 yards on the catch there. Brings up second down.
It's a gain of 5. Brings up second and 5.
The gun, McAllister, and that is incomplete. A lot of force bearing down on him there. He could not hang on. It's third down.
As his old brain remembers, when I see 5 wide receivers on the field as a defender, I know the ball's coming out hot. They expected it and got there and popped it free.
From the gun on third down, McAllister is going to float this one deep right side. And that will be incomplete with a clock showing 18 seconds now to go.
Well, Well, they came up with points in their first two possessions, but it looks like they'll come up empty here on their third drive. The defense finally starting to get locked into them a little bit. Might have to go a little bit deeper into their playbook on their next possession.
And he gets this up across the 35 before he's out of bounds. It's a 49-yard punt, but subtract 9 there for the return. And control of the football, switching hands with very little time remaining until the half. KC offense out of the huddle, ready for their next drive. And from this spot in the field with the clock where it's at, you think we're just going to see a knee and that's it?
And I think in this situation, that's the proper play. But we do know there's some risk takers out there that may want to take one more shot before the clock runs out.
8 yards on the pickup brings up second and 2 at the 46-yard line.
And unless this is a quick incompletion, this is likely the last play here of this first half. A final shot before break. Meadows. And this will be incomplete. 1 second left to go.
On the deep ball. Brings up 3rd down and 2.
After the incompletion, here now, 3rd and 2. And now they'll take a timeout defensively. After the 2nd down play, they burn the timeout, making him sweat out the final few ticks here in the 2nd quarter. An incomplete pass on that last play, and that means they'll need to come up with something here on 3rd down. And they're well past midfield, just 1 yard or 2 shy of the 40. So we've hit halftime, just 1 field goal separating these 2 teams at the break. As we'll send you down to Orlando, we check in with Jonathan Coachman for our EA Sports Halftime Report. Coach, ready for the start of the 3rd quarter. The Chiefs have the lead and set to receive the football. And a decent return out to the 27-yard line.
Take over 1st and 10 at their own 27-yard line.
The Chiefs offense about set to begin this drive. We have not seen much on offense from either side these last few drives. It has been a struggle, hasn't it?
Totally, and you're thinking to yourself right now, if you're on offense trying to get things figured out, okay, we self-scout every week on our game plan. How many things do we do at certain times? What are our tendencies? Time to go to some of those tendency breakers and try and create some offense.
They always have those in their back. And he's going to be intercepted 3rd time. Picked off around the 41. And they'll start with great field position at the 41-yard line.
41-yard line.
They'll try to get the run game going. This is Mixon. 8 yards on the pickup, and now they'll have some options on 2nd and short.
He's tackled at the 32-yard line. It's a gain of 8. Brings up 2nd and 2.
Operating from the gun, McAllister. Throwing right, and that's complete. And he's able to get it down to the 25-yard line.
To number 82.
That one, a 1st down pickup of 8.
And a Brooklyn 1st down.
They'll try the left side. Gibson. And he's going to take this one down to about the 23-yard line. 2 yards on the pickup there. It'll be 2nd and 8.
Well, sometimes as a running back, you've got to be able to improvise when the hole's not where you expect it to be. But in this case, there wasn't any improvisation that he could do that was going to work. Kind of like if you're trying to be a comedian on open mic night at the improv and you run into a tough crowd.
The last run good for 2. Here's 2nd and 8. Screen. They keep it on the ground. This time it's Mixon. And he takes it down to the 10-yard line. The pickup goes for 13 and sets him up first and goal.
First and goal at the 10-yard line.
To throw. McAllister, they'll set up the screen here to Mixon. And he'll be brought down here at the 3-yard line. A gain of 7 that time. Second goal.
For a second there, I thought that might break big. Screen pass. Looked like it was coming together. Looked like there was an opening. Still ended up with a solid gain.
So the ball position now at the 3. Here's second and goal. From the gun, McAllister, and it's caught. Touchdown.
McAllister
from 3 yards out. And his guys are going to retake the lead.
You get down near the goal line, this is where having a sure-handed tight end becomes a luxury. And it pays off big time, especially when the defense sells out against the run. And he finds himself open for an easy touchdown.
Set to kick off.
So with the missed PAT in his rearview mirror, he goes back out to kick this one off. Taken in at the 3. And he takes this near the 25. Just a little pass there. Call it the 26.
At their own 26-yard line.
KC offense out of the huddle, ready for their next drive. And last time wasn't pretty. One play and an interception. We'll see if they can do better.
I want to see if they want to go ahead and throw the ball again now on this drive after what happened on the last one. Throw it on the first play. Give the quarterback some confidence.
See what happens. Call it a gain of 5, and it'll be second down.
Brings up second and 5 at the 32-yard line.
Operating from the gun, Meadows. Hunter Henry brings it in. And he'll be tackled right on the chalk of the 45. Give him 14 on that one and a first down.
Nice job there of utilizing his big target. He didn't overthink it. Understands the catch radius. Understands that he knows how to use his body to keep defenders away from the ball. And puts it right out there for the nice pickup.
Throwing on first down. Meadows finding Harris over the middle.
Meadows pass.
That catch good for only a couple. So second and 8 here after the pass play for 2 yards on first down.
At the 47-yard line.
From the gun, Meadows. He'll rifle this one deep right side. And it's knocked away and incomplete.
But you got to think that sooner or later, they're going to hit one of those. But the coverage has been excellent thus far, and it was again on the last play.
So the failure to connect on second down, that leaves them staring up here at a 3rd and 8. And he'll lose yardage on the play back at the 45-yard line. Fourth down now after a loss of 2.
I think this running game, or should I say lack of one, is making this defense look better than what they really are.
Here's Logan Cook now as he's on a punt for the first time this afternoon. He'll send this one into the Midwestern air, and it's a good one. Now this is going to carry well into the end zone for a touchback.
At their own 20-yard line.
The offense now at the line, ready for their next drive. First down, McAllister
Flushed out right. And now he's going to use his legs. He'll wind up getting right about four there on the scramble, and it's second down.
Now, how about that play? He took a possible negative and turned it into positive yardage and slid down to avoid taking a big shot. Excellent job getting down and avoiding the big hit.
They'll come up second and six now from the 24. Now with just 1 second showing on the play clock, we're going to get a timeout. It's just their first, so two remaining as they burn one here in this third quarter. 6 yards left on second down. From the gun, a give to Mixon. And he'll get this one up to the 26.
Joe Mixon.
2 yards the game there, and now they're left with a third and about four for a first.
And it's third.
That's out to the left and complete. And he'll have it past midfield almost to the 40 before being taken down. A gain of 32 that time. Mixon with a first down carry. And he's going to get this inside the 30.
Mixon, the ball carrier.
Add the gain here to the previous play, and it's better than 40 yards total.
A gain of 13 yards. First down.
On first and 10. McAllister, he gets this in the hands of Mixon. That catch good for only a couple.
Well, offensively, that's the mismatch that you want. You want to force a linebacker to try and cover your back out of the backfield, out in some open space. The linebackers nowadays, they run like backs, and they take a lot of pride in covering. What a nice play he made there in the open field.
On second down, it's Gibson. It'll be a gain of 5, but still about 3 yards shy of the first down marker, and now it's third down.
What a luxury to have a guy like this who can not only spell your starter, but can come in and keep drives going.
16, Chiefs 13.
The offense on third down, they've had good success, 5 for 8 to this point. Here it's 3rd and 3. A quick throw complete into the flat out left. And he picks up the first down yardage as he takes it down to the 16.
It's a
pickup of 6 and good enough to move the chains.
First down.
We saw a number of good games earlier today. This one might top all of those. It's been a dandy as we come up on 1st and 10. And he can't get rid of it. He's taken down.
Well, someone's closing in on the league lead in sacks. He came into the game in the top 5. Now you add 2 more to his total.
That huge loss on the sack makes this job much more difficult. It's now 2nd down and 22 yards to go. Operating from the gun, McAllister looking for his tight end on the corner. It's complete. And he's able to work it here to the 8-yard line.
Complete.
A big gain there after going backwards, and that'll lead to a 3rd down.
But it's 3rd down.
They're trying to keep the drive going. This will be play number 8. It's 3rd and 2. From the gun, McAllister. This will be caught at about the 6. And he's able to pick up the first before he's brought down inside the 5 at the 4.
And goal.
4 yards on the play, and that leads to the 1st and goal. So 1st and goal, 6 points here would go a long way toward wrapping this one up. They'll give it to Mixon, and he'll take it into the end zone for a touchdown. Joe Mixon hitting double digits with his 10th touchdown of the season, and his guys are going to add on to their lead. A solid blocking up front from the guys on the offensive line allowed him to get in for the touchdown.
Yeah, some might say that the guys on the offensive line were in concert. I used to have a coach who called it marrying up, meaning when you get on a guy, you just just stay right there. Each guy has his own assignment that allowed the runner to make the big move towards the end zone.
The Chiefs offense about set to begin this drive. And you figure after giving up that last touchdown, you know, they trail by two scores here in the fourth quarter. This drive becomes very critical. Throwing on first down. Meadows, nowhere to go here. He lost the football. It's going the other way. And he's going to bring the fumble back for a touchdown.
Dustin Hopkins.
The offense, they've had some sloppy moments. Sloppy there again on that one, and it could be the backbreaker.
From a defensive perspective, if the offense is going to be sloppy, you've got to take advantage of that. That's what they've done all game long.
Hopkins with the extra point, and that'll make this a three-score game now. The lead moves to 17. And this will not be returnable. It's out of the back of the end zone for a touchback.
25-yard line.
The KC offense out of the huddle, ready for their next drive. And you see a lot of frustrated faces as they are inching closer to a fourth straight loss. He's going to fire this thing deep right sideline. And that will be incomplete. Would have been a big hitter if they had connected. Instead, it's second down.
This defense was definitely alert to the possibility of the deep ball, and they were more than ready for it.
They've got the lead, fourth quarter. Maybe can expect more passes like that downfield. Throwing again on second and 10. Meadows. Flush to his right. On the run, he'll let it go deep, right sideline. And that's going to be incomplete. Good effort there, trying to take a shot, but it's third down.
We've seen that the deep ball's been a part of their game plan all afternoon, but they've had trouble hooking up on it, unable to successfully find the end zone over the top.
The Chiefs on third down. They've been okay, 2 for 3 thus far. This is third and 10. And he will lose yardage and be backed up to the 24. A loss of a yard, and it brings up fourth.
A loss of a yard. It's fourth down.
On fourth down, Meadows. He's got his man. That's Hardman. And he goes out of bounds just shy of the 45. But no reason not to try it there, and they do indeed convert on fourth. So signs of life in what's been a dormant offense in this second half. Here's first and 10. And this one's going to go the wrong way, losing yardage back at the 42. That one unable to develop, never got going. A loss of a couple, and it's second down.
Second and 12 at the 42-yard line.
Operating from the gun, Meadows. This pass going to be caught by Hardman. And they'll get this well past midfield before being stopped just before the 35. 22 yards there, a first down.
First and 10 at the 36-yard line.
From the gun, Meadows, and he rifles one incomplete. Mecole Hardman, the intended target, but it'll be second down.
At this point in the game, they've got to continue to try anything they can. They're still working at it, even though this one feels like a lost cause.
They'll try again from the 36 on second and 10. Throwing again, Meadows, and his pass is intercepted for the fourth time today. The safety Terrell Edmonds picks it. And a terrific return as he'll take it up past the 35.
First and 10.
Well, just another reason to celebrate there on the defensive side with the interception. And this is a game that they clearly have firmly in their grasp.
Yeah, a lot of handshakes, a lot of hugs, a lot of smiles. It's been their day.
The offense back out there at the line, ready for their next drive. And after the interception, they are sitting in an even better spot with the ball and a comfortable fourth quarter lead. That's going to be caught by Samuel. And out of bounds on the other side of midfield at the 45. This drive starting off on the right foot, 18 yards.
Down Bulls.
They'll run on first down. Mixon. It's a 7-yard carry to set them up with a second and 3.
Oh, that's one to warm the hearts of all those old school football players, isn't it? Tough, hard, gritty run. Got behind his pads, bowled over a few people. Look at that one, right up the gut.
So up through three quarters, no reason to lighten up now. And this time, not quite to the 30. It'll be down at the 31-yard line. 7 yards there and a first down.
A gain of 7. First down, Brooklyn.
Off the play fake. McAllister steps away to his left. Now he'll pull it down. And he'll be out of bounds just inside the 25-yard line. Nice work to get 7 out of that, and it's second down.
They brought the blitz that time, and I thought they were going to get to him, but instead, he flipped it on its ear and ended up picking up positive yardage.
I thought he was dead to rights, but you are exactly correct, sir. Able to turn that into a positive gain. And he'll be brought down at the 21, just shy of the 20 in the red zone.
No pain, no gain.
So it's our visitors with a football as we get you reset. And no doubt what they're looking to do is just salt away the final couple of minutes and escape with a win. He'll buy some time right. And it's caught. Touchdown. Curtis Samuel, his 9th touchdown of the season. And his guys find a way to stretch that lead. They were still throwing with a comfortable lead here late, and now that lead even more comfortable.
And your first thought is there bad blood that went into this one ahead of time, that maybe they're seeking some revenge or they just don't like them? But the other thing that always hits me is, are they worried about playoff positioning? Right? Are they worried about, do you need enough points in case there's a tiebreaker that comes into play later?
The Chiefs offense about set to begin this drive. Let's just be frank. They're playing for pride at this point.
That's all that's left, because victory, not a chance now. And I can't wait to see how they actually go about doing it, because there are a lot of people watching the body language of the guys on the field now, and if they call plays they want executed, they need to do that and do it really well. Otherwise, there could be repercussions.
We'll see how they handle the waning moments of this one. 9 yards to pick up there, and it's a first down.
At the 39-yard line.
Now whistles and a flag down. Looked like one of the Chief linemen might have moved. False start backs him up 5, first and 15. Looking to throw. Meadows completes it to Hardman. And he'll be taken down, but not before they work it across midfield. The Chiefs will use the first of their timeouts as they'll head to the sideline and talk over what to do next. So signs of life in what's been a dormant offense in this second half. Here's first and 10. Back to throw. Meadows. Now a desperation throw deep downfield. And nearly another interception. They've been around the ball all game.
Well, when you've got a tight end who can run, you've got to give him a shot to unlock the defense. Want to see what they can get? Taking the big shot downfield. That one winds up incomplete.
Back to the air on second down. Meadows, he's going to let it fly. And that will be incomplete. Meadows tried to dial up the long way way out there, but it'll be third down.
Well, we've talked about it, CD, but it bears repeating. They are struggling to throw the football. All the interceptions and more incompletions. It just doesn't look like things are in sync out there.
I would agree with that, and it's not a good day when you feel like an incomplete pass is almost a win for you because it wasn't intercepted. And I think the receivers now, when they're running their routes, they want to catch the ball, but they also want to make sure that the defenders don't take it away.
Now a desperation throw deep downfield, and that will be incomplete. Well, they weren't scared to let it fly, but it falls to the ground and brings up fourth down.
I usually hesitate when I say a guy's got world-class speed, but this guy might. So let's fire the starter's pistol. Let's go. If you've got him, you've got to try and use him. A lot of anticipation with the ball in the air, but no, incomplete.
The three straight incompletions, they don't care. That hasn't dissuaded them. They're going to go for it on fourth. As expected, they're going for it to keep the drive alive. And this is incomplete. They had to go for it with such little time remaining. And as a result, possession switches hands. The offense now at the line, ready for their next drive. They're in control here as they start first and 10, and appearing to have righted the ship following that two-game losing streak. Now the first play of the drive there is incomplete.
I think he's got to be careful not to force anything into coverage right there. There weren't really any throwing lanes, but the best part for him, he's got second and third down to fall back on.
So now second and 10 after the incompletion on first down. That one looks like he'll throw here. That's Samuel, caught left side. Yeah, he's going to be out of bounds, but not before he takes it inside the 40. That one good for a first down pickup of 18 yards. Operating from the gun, McAllister. Got a man over the middle, it's Williams.
McAllister's
and brought down, but not before they're inside the 25. Another nice gain, that's now 30 yards between those last two plays. On first down, McAllister, his throw caught at about the 5. And they are going to score again. Yet another touchdown as they just add to their totals.
Well, partner, when a team's up this big, this late in the game, I always wonder what's their motivation, because if it's me, I'm thinking about pulling on the reins a little bit. But for them, I don't think it's in their DNA. It's not in their head coach's makeup at all. I think his opinion is, you stop us, we're not supposed to pull back ourselves.
And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25. The KC offense out of the huddle, ready for their next drive. They are just obviously getting shellacked here in this one, Charles. What's the message if you're a coach for this final drive in a lopsided game like this?
For a lot of coaches,
be honest,
don't forget today. Don't forget what has happened out here.
Yeah, use that as ammo
going
forward.
Exactly. Take a great look at that scoreboard. Realize how poorly everything went for us today, coaching, playing, the whole deal. And never forget it, because
you're not going to want that feeling
again. No, you don't want that feeling again. And who knows? You may meet up with this team again.
On first and 10, Meadows, and he's going to drop this off to his fullback. And the clock will now stop as a timeout is called with 5 seconds left.
At the 36-yard line.
loss of three on that first down pass play. Now second and 13. One final shot. They'll look to throw. And now here is another interception. Picked off at the 35. There he goes, left side.